Bearded Science Guy here, and today I'm going to show you how with $5 and a little bit of elbow grease, you can be building rockets capable of launching an entire football field. To start with, wrap a sheet of cardstock around a 1/2 inch PVC pipe. Make sure that the cardstock slides freely along the PVC pipe, or else the rocket won't launch when it comes time. Then take a piece of electrical tape and tape the cardstock in place. After a few more pieces of tape, you have now completed the body of your rocket. The next step is to seal up the front end of your rocket. Now be careful. Most of the pressure of the rocket launch will be placed on this front end, so make sure you tape it shut really well. After you've completed sealing up the end of your rocket, the next step is to choose a nose cone. There are a lot of different types of nose cones you could choose, but for this demonstration, we're going to use a pointed nose cone. Take a piece of cardstock and roll it into a cone. Now using electrical tape, tape the cone in place so it doesn't slide around. The nose cone is way too big for our rocket as is. So what you need to do is figure out where you need to cut it at. Take the body of your rocket and slide it into the nose cone and feel where the rocket meets the edge of the nose cone. This is where you need to cut it. Once you have the nose cone cut to size, you can trim up the edges so that there's a nice fit between the body of your rocket and the nose cone. Then tape the nose cone in place. Once your nose cone has been taped in place, now you're ready for your tail fins. Start by designing your tail fins on a blank piece of paper. Here, I've decided to use 3 triangle tail fins. But you can use a different number of tail fins, or decide on a different shape for your tail fins altogether. Once you have the tail fins cut out, now you're ready to attach them to the body of your rocket. Here, we'll be using electrical tape to do this, but you can use any number of adhesives to get the job done. Tape both sides of the tail fin to the rocket body if you want it to stand straight out perpendicular to the rocket body. Once you've attached all the tail fins, your rocket's ready to fly. Now we just need to build a launcher. And for this launcher, we're going to use a 2-liter bottle, 1/2 inch PVC pipe, and electrical tape. To start building your launcher, first you need a base. I've chosen to use 3 1/2 inch PVC pipes taped together, but you could very easily use a 2x4 or some other sturdy base to keep the rocket launcher steady. Once you have your base constructed, take the 2-liter bottle and insert a section of 1/2 inch PVC pipe. It should be a very snug fit. However, it's still a good idea to use electrical tape so that this connection doesn't come loose during launching. Now connect a threaded 90-degree turn elbow using the same method with electrical tape. The reason we're using threaded elbows is so that you can adjust the angle at which you're launching the rockets. Now connect the second elbow and your final piece of 1/2 inch PVC pipe. Thank you. The final step in the process is taping the launcher to the base we made in step one. Once the tape is secured, your rocket launcher is ready to fire. These rockets have the ability to travel almost 100 yards. So it's a good idea to use eye protection and be outside when you're testing your rocket launcher. Load your rocket on the end of the 1/2-inch PVC pipe, and then stomp on the 2-liter bottle and watch it fly.